Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Today I will give you a summary of Isavasyopanishad, which can be called as Isopanishad. Isavasyopanishad or Isopanishad. This Upanishad contains the entire Vedic teaching. Very small Upanishad with 18 mantras. Only 18. This Upanishad belong to Shukla Yajurveda. Shukla Yajurvediya Upanishad. First two mantras talks about Jnana Marga and Karma Marga. The first mantra, the first line, talks about the goal of life. First mantra, first line. Isha Vasya Midagum Sarvam Yatkincha Jagatyam Jagat. That is the goal of every human being. Then in second line of the first mantra, the Nivritti Marga, Sannyasa Marga is given. Then the second mantra talks about Karma Yoga, Pravritti Marga or Grihasthashrama. This is what is the first line essence. Isavasyam idam sarvam. Every human being should see the world, prapancham, idagum sarvam, means this whole universe. The prapancha which is in front of us has to be seen as Ishvara, the Paramatma. Isavasyam. Vasyam means pervaded. The whole universe is pervaded by Ishvara only. That is the idea communicated in the first line. Therefore, prapancha drishti, that we see it as world, prapancha drishti has to be replaced by Ishvara drishti, Paramatma drishti. Perspective change. Perspective change means in my vision, in my perception, the world is nothing but Ishvara. That bhavana should come. Then it has to become knowledge. Yes, whole universe is nothing but Ishvara. If I choose this, it is a spiritual life, it is called a spiritual life. If I change the prapancha drishti to Ishvara drishti, I am leading a spiritual life. This is the goal of life. There is no other goal for any human being in the world. Final, ultimate goal. Isavasyam idagum sarvam. Yat kincha jagatyam jagat. Whatever is there, without any exception. Everything is Ishvara without any exception. Whatever you see, Nama Rupa, is nothing but Anatma. That Anatma is nothing but Karyam. Karanam is Ishvaraha. Just as the ornaments cannot exist separate from gold, gold alone is appearing as ornaments. Ornaments are non-separate from gold. Really speaking, there are no ornaments other than gold. This is very, very clear for us. Same way you apply to the world. World is like an ornament. It is only a word. Ornament also is a word. Chain is also a word. Bangle is also a word given to the gold. So gold alone was there, is there, will be there. Really speaking, ornament is only a word. Similarly, world is also a word. It is only on your lip movements. You have to see it as Ishvara, the Karanam. Karyam doesn't exist really. So whenever you get doubt whether this world is Bhagavan or not, immediately go to the example. This bangle is real or not? You will come to conclusion it is not real. Like that you have to do contemplation. One day or other you recognize that whole universe is nothing but Ishvara. But this knowledge is not so easy. So Upanishad presents two lifestyles for that. You can choose any lifestyle to get this jnanam. What jnanam? Replacing the prapancha drishti to Ishvara drishti. God alone was there, God alone is there, God alone will be there. That God whom we are calling in religion, in Vedanta we call that God as Satchidananda, Sat Chit Ananda Swarupam, Paramatma, Lakshyartha Ishvara. Vachyartha Ishvara is only for Vyavaharikam. For our karma yoga, upasana yoga, abhyasa, Vachyartha Ishvara is introduced. Originally, Paramatma or Ishvara is, Lakshyartha Ishvara is, Satchidananda Swarupam. This knowledge one has to gain. Second line says, Isavasyam idagam sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat. How to know this truth, how to assimilate this truth, how to make this is fact in our life now. Tena tyaktena bhunchi thaha. One has to take a lifestyle that is withdrawal lifestyle. Sannyasi lifestyle. Sannyasa yoga or sannyasa ashrama. Chaktena bhunjita. May you not covet others' wealth. Means what? Drop everything. Don't crave for possessions. Lead like a sannyasi. This is one lifestyle. Straight away jnana marga you can go. But this is very, very difficult. It is not for all people. Therefore, you can choose another marga also, grihastha marga. Karma yoga, upasana yoga, sadhana dwara. You can attain the same knowledge. You cannot avoid this knowledge. You can postpone. Those who come to Jnana Marga, Sannyasa Marga, they get this knowledge within 10 years, suppose. If you enter Grihastha Ashrama, do Karma Yoga, Upasana Yoga, you will get it 30 years, that's all. But you cannot say, no, 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 I cannot afford for this knowledge. You cannot say. You can postpone, you can choose your ashrama, whatever you like, but you cannot say this replacement of prapancha drishti to Ishvara drishti, you cannot avoid. Why? If you avoid not knowing this universe as Bhagavan, if you avoid that, you will have bhayam, samsara. Samsara, rupa, bhayam, insecurity, all will come. Why? What is the reason? When you see the prapancha as prapancha, it is dvaita drishti. When you look at the prapancha as prapancha, it is dvaita drishti. Dvaita drishti means what? Dvitiya dvai bhayam bhavati. As long as you see dvaitam, duality as a reality, you cannot avoid fear. Bhayam bhavati. Dvitiya dvai bhayam bhavati. So, jagat Ishvara rupena na drishyate chet bhayam bhavati. That's why people are all under fear. They're all always under threat. Because they see abhaye bhaya darshinaha. Dvaita darshanam is equal to bhayam. Bhayam is equal to samsara. So ball is in your court. Choose what you want. You want to continue in bhayam all the time, fear? Continue. No, 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 I cannot withstand with this fear, insecurity. Then you have to come. Advaita darshanam, only Ishvara darshanam, advaita darshanam. Abhayam, no bhayam. Advaita darshanam is equal to Atma darshanam. Atma darshanam is equal to abhayam. Abhayam is equal to moksha. So decide. By telling this reason and that reason, if you go on postponing, you will continue in this anatma, dvaitam, bhayam, insecurity, limitation. All the way you face lot of problems in your life. Therefore, choose, decide and take to that spiritual goal. Once you come to that spiritual goal, take two lifestyles, one up that. Grihasthashrama, karma yoga upasana. Kurvanneveha karmani jaje vishet. That is grihasthashrama, karma yoga lifestyle. This is the introduction. One and two verses, mantras. Very, very powerful mantras. First line, goal of life. Second line and second verse, both of them two lifestyles. What Bhagavan Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, Lokesmin dvividha nishtha pura prokta mayanagha jnana yogena sankhyanam karma yogena yoginam. I have given two lifestyles. They can choose, they have option, they have choice. But the goal to attain, they have no choice. Everyone has to attain. So this is the first two verses, introduction of the subject matter. And how to attain, the marga also given. Then in the third mantra, it is a warning like, if you avoid this knowledge, suppose, what will happen? You will go to Swargaloka and you will come back All for artha, kama, you are only struggling throughout your life. Not giving importance to the guru, shastra, teaching, spiritual life is not there. Throughout your life you are enjoying, but next life, next janma, again and again, andhantama pravishanti, atmahanaha iti. They are exactly suiciding themselves. It is like a suicide, killing oneself, not knowing their real nature, not seeing everything as Brahman or Atman, and seeing oneself as Atman, not claiming oneself as Atma, Brahman, is called suicide. Equal to suicide. Atmahanaha, the word is used by the Upanishad. The guru and the disciple names are not given in this Upanishad. It is not in dialogue form, like Kathopanishad, Mundakopanishad. But this Upanishad alone is giving teaching for us. The rishis are declaring in the form of this Upanishadic teaching. There is no particular guru and disciple name here. We don't get any dialogue here. Sambhada Rupam is not there. That is why wherever Sambhada is not there, all those places Upanishads are very tough to grasp. Even Keno Upanishad, where Guru is talking, where Sishya is talking, we do not know. You have to decipher. This is very, very terse Upanishad. Isavasyopanishad is mantra bhaga of Brahmana bhaga Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Brihadaranyaka means Brahmana bhaga. It is a prose. This is mantra bhaga, it is a verse form. Always verse forms are always abridged. Very, very terse and depth is there. This one Upanishad is expanded in Brihadaranyaka, vast Upanishad. You can understand how big that Upanishad, how small this is. Upanishad itself comment and magnify its own teaching. Isavasyopanishad is magnified in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. That is why it is a Brahmana Bhaga. After giving this much in first 2-3 verses, now from 4th mantra onwards up to 8th mantra, the Upanishad gives description of Atma. What you have to recognize, realize, or discover, that is Atma. That Ishvara is nothing but Atma. What is that Atman nature, Ishvara's nature? The description is given in Nivritti Marga or Pravritti Marga, whatever you can take, but the truth you have to work for, Atma Swarupam. There are many verses. 6th and 7th mantras are very, very important mantras. Now I give you the important features of Atma, what Upanishad presents here. Saparyaga, Shukram, Akayam, Avranam, Asna, Viragum, all those are descriptions of Atma. Very, very terse words, they are all having lot of in-depth meaning. Number one is, Atma is Chaitanya Rupaha. First description. Atma is Chaitanya Rupaha means, Atma is of the nature of consciousness. Atma is of the nature of consciousness. Consciousness is called Atma. Atma is called consciousness. Atma doesn't have an attribute called consciousness. It is not an attribute. It is the nature of Atma. It is not a guna. Many other philosophers take it as a guna. It is Atma guna. Chaitanyam is Atma Guna they take. Therefore, lot of commentary Shankaracharya writes on this. In his mantras, he says, Atma is Chaitanya Swarupaha, number one. That is the meaning, Saparyaga Shukram Akayam Amranam. Number two, second description of Atma is Akayam Avranam Asnaviradam. That means Atma is Shariratraya Vilakshanaha, free from three bodies. It doesn't have gross body, it doesn't have subtle body, it doesn't have causal body. Atma is free from three bodies. Shariratraya Vilakshanaha. This is the second print definition of Atma. Atma is not a product of the body or part of the body, property of the body. Atma's third feature is that Atma, the consciousness, is not limited by the boundaries of the body. Sarvagataha Atma. Saparyaga. Paryaga means all pervading. It is not limited by the body mind complex. All pervading. Boundaries are not there for Atma. It is free from all limitations. Boundaries of the bodies cannot limit the Atma. Therefore, Sarvagataha. First one is, Atma is Shuddhaha, or Chaitanya Swarupaha, number one. Number two is Shariratraya Vilakshanaha. Number three is Sarvagataha. Number four, the fourth description given is, Atma, the consciousness, continues even after the fall of the body. Body may die, but Atma will never die. Atma continues. What people talk, the soul travel continues, that is not original Atma. That is not original Atma. Original Atma cannot travel. Therefore, this Atma is eternal. Before body was coming, Atma was there. When body is here, Atma is there. When body goes also, Atma will be there. Therefore, Nityaha. Nitya Sarvagatasthanuhu Achaloyam Sanatanaha. Lord Krishna borrowed from these mantras only in second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Atma Nityaha. Then fifth definition or description of Atma is Achalaha. Same Bhagavad Gita, Achaloyam Sanatanaha, Bhagavan said, Achalaha, Tan Ejati, Tan Nejati. Atma as though moves, but it doesn't move. Like space. Can space move? All pervading one cannot move. It is not possible. Sarvagatatvat Achalaha. Just as the space cannot move, Atma also cannot move. Why? All pervading. If it is not there in one place and not there in another place only, it has to move. It can move. Since Atma is everywhere, it cannot move. In the form of Sat and Chit, it is there. Atma means don't take one padartha somewhere outside. It is formless. It is formless. You cannot see it as an object somewhere outside. So, Atma is Achalaha. Tadejati tannejati. Upanishad used the words. It moves as it were, but it never moves. Achalaha. Then, number six. Shuddham apapa vidham. Papa punya cannot touch the Atma. It is pure, ever pure. all the doshas, vyadhi, jara, marana, which are belong to body, cannot afflict the atma. It is pure. Body has got lot of impurities. These impurities of the body cannot touch the atma, even though atma is within the body. Very, very interesting. Even that dāham, the hunger, thirst of pranamaya kosha cannot make that atma to suffer with hunger and thirst. Even atma is free from shoka, moha of that mind. Mind has got that dosha of raga, dvesha. Doshas are there. Atma cannot have those doshas. Therefore, shuddhaha. Shuddham apapa vidhamana. By papa it can never be striked. That means papa can never come and touch the atma. Therefore, never say, I am a papi. I am a papi, and again, what do you mean by I there? You have to understand. That is why, if you don't have this knowledge, that person is called Moodaha. Shastra says, most unintelligent person in the world is Ajnani. Those whoever avoid this knowledge and spending time in other things, and they are looking topmost priority for that person, means in front of Shastra is the most unfortunate person. Kripanaha, Shastra says. Now the seventh feature is Atma Ekaha. It is only one. Bodies are many, but Atmas, Jivatmas, bodies only, 10 bodies are there. 10 Jivatmas are there, you cannot say. 10 mirrors are there, 10 faces are appearing. You can say there are 10 faces. How many faces are there really? Only one face. Why it is appearing as 10? Because of medium. Since you are seeing 10 faces in the mirror, I am 10, you can say that. 10 faces you can count. Like that, here also, every mind is like a mirror. In that mind, one Atma reflecting as Chidabhasa, as Jiva, as Ahankara. You cannot say there are many Jivatmas. One Atma, whenever you have got doubt, there are many Jivas I am seeing. You go to that mirror hall in the temples. Last week I went to Kalahasti. I saw that mirror hall. No, you go to that mirror hall. How beautiful idea they kept in that temples. We are thinking it is for Swamiji ki unjal sevai. That's why they keep unjal in the middle and mirrors around. That is not the real idea. You go and move again and again in the temple and go to that hall, mirror hall, and you see you are one and you appear as many. As many mirrors, hundreds of faces you can see, hundreds of bodies. There you recognize that I am one, appearing as many. Similarly, I am one Atma, appearing as Jivatma, appearing as Paramatma, appearing as Jagat. Subject is myself. Object is also myself, instrument is also myself, sarvam ahameva. This knowledge you have to get after going to mirror hall. People look at their face, how they are looking, and they come out. You see, that only they see. That child can do that, seeing that mirror and playing, child can do, not elderly person. Elderly person is not supposed to look at the hairstyle, dress, color, face. You are also looking like that. What is the difference between you and the child? This is the idea in our religious practices. Everywhere they hint somewhere or other, you have to recognize that where they are talking about this Advaita Jnana. That is Advaita Jnana. They're all reflections. For that you require for 10 years of study to understand, to see that mirror hall is for this analysis. 10 years if you study only, you can make use of that mirror hall. What purpose they have kept? Have you gone anywhere? In Chennai it is there? Tirumala illa, Andhra la every temple has got. In Chennai. Okay. Tamil Nadu, okay, very good. If temples they are there, go and sit there. See, they won't allow to sit. You have to go round and come out. Anyhow. So the Atma is ekaha only. Jivatma, Jivatma Bheda is not there. Jivatma, Paramatma is not, Bheda is not there. One Atma alone. Next, this is seventh feature. Eighth feature is Atma Dvirupaha. Atma has got two forms. One is reflected, another is original. That is what this mirror example. I, the Atma, am alone appearing in the form of Chidabhasa. That's my lower eye. That lower eye has got hunger, thirst, and soka, moha, reflection. If a mirror has got some cracks, face also appears with cracks, some breaks there and there. If it is dirty, reflected face also appear as dirty, but not original face. Clear? Therefore, that is my lower eye. Reflected face like reflected consciousness. What is the medium? There, mirror. Here, mind, not body. Physical body cannot, this is a very, very gross material, matter. It cannot reflect consciousness. So that mind has made out of subtle matter, therefore reflects. This is one future. Consciousness is OC and RC. OC is real, RC is unreal. RCI is my Vesham, OC is Vishi. OC is Veshi, the one who puts the Vesham, RC. As husband role, wife role, daughter role, brother role, sister role, all are Vesham. But Vesham we are taking as real. Veshi we have forgotten. That is a tragedy. Life is a tragedy if you forget you are a Veshi. You take yourself as Vesham, as real. Life is a tragedy. When life is comedy, santosham, entertainment, I am putting Vesham, I am really OC, the Veshi, the one who puts the Vesham. Simple, the Vedanta is very simple. It looks simple, but to assimilate, it takes time. The ninth feature is Atma can never be seen as an object outside. It is ever the subject, never the object. Adrishto, drashta, amator, manta. It is the hearer can never be heard. It is the seer can never be seen. Atma is the seer, can never be seen or not object. It is ever the thinker, cannot be thought of. Atma aprameyaha, aprameya svaprakasha, manovacha magochara. Once you chant the Lalita Sahasrama, slowly you will come to Vedanta class. In Lalita Devi bless you. by chanting go on aprameya swaprakasha, one day she will pushes you somehow to Vedanta class. Whether you understand or not, it is your problem, not her problem. Okay? That word to understand, you have to study here many years. Understand? Okay. That is a ninth feature. Then tenth feature is Atma is just like Akasha, Atma is just like Prakasha. It's like a light, it's like a space. Therefore, do Atma Dhyanam as Akasha Dhyanam, Prakasha Dhyanam. You do, you will get the clarity about Atma. Akashavat, Prakashavat. So Atma, meditate upon Atma as space and light, because similar futures. Akhandaha, indivisible, is the tenth feature. Atma is akhandaha, indivisible. Nataka Deepa Prakaranam in Panchadashi, Vidyaranya says, in front of light, everything is appearing. Similarly, in front of consciousness, because I the consciousness, everything is evident. Atma Prakasha Rupaha is the tenth definition. Atma is Akasha Rupaha and Prakasha Rupaha. Just as Akasha accommodate, I the Atma accommodate every Nama Rupa in me. Just like space accommodate everything, I am like Akasha Rupaha, I accommodate everyone. I am Prakasha Rupaha means in presence of me everything is known or evident. Therefore, these are the closer words upon which I have to do Dhyana. Akasha and Prakasha. Atma is just like Akasha and Prakasha. Many common features are there. Then 11th and last and final one is Atma is Karanam. For this entire universe, Sarva Adharam, Sarva Adhara Rupa Karanam, Sarva Adharam, Vishwadharam, Gagana Sadrisham. All words are familiar only. Vishnu Sahasranama, Lalita Sahasranama. To understand that, you require Upanishadic background. So, Atma is Sarva Adhara Rupa Karanam, Sarva Sara Rupa Karanam. Sarva Sara, essence of everything. Therefore, Advaitam. This is the last and final one. Advaitam means Karana, Karya are only two words. Really, Atma is non-dual, Advaitam. Karya Karana Vilakshanam. This is very, very important. Karya Karana, both are Mula Karanam is Atma. Advaitam Brahma Ahamasmi. There is no second real thing in the world. All are only Namarupa. Now, what is the benefit of knowing this? Upanishad gives the meaning, last na, two, three benefits are there. Shoka Nivritti and Moha Nivritti. He is free from sorrow. Tatra ko shoko mohaha kas shokaha ekatva manupashyataha. In seventh mantra, the benefit is given. He is free from sorrow. He is free from delusion. No more Brahma Pranti. Therefore, don't postpone to study Shastra thoroughly, intensely. Don't postpone. All Maya comes and attracts you, pulls you. Namarupa Prapancha. Earn money more. and buy a house, buy a car, go on and on pushing. And a person is struggling and spending whole time for that. Shastra says, Ippiravi tappinal, Ippiravi vaikkumo. If you miss this life, you do not know what life you are going to get. Therefore, shoka nivritti, moha nivritti. Then third benefit is, na vijugupsate. He will not have any type of insecurity. Free from insecurity. Jugupsa means insecurity. Atma jnanam dvara jugupsa nivrittihi na vijugupsate. He will not have any insecurity, he will not have any delusion, he will not have any sorrow. Now we'll go to the next verse, mantra 9-14, second part of the Upanishad is Pravritti Marga. So the first Atma Jnanam can be attained through Nivritti Marga, also Sannyasa Jnana Yoga Marga. No, I am not able to understand, I am not able to come to the class. Do Karma Yoga Panchamaha Yajnas. Enter into Grihasthashrama, happily have some responsibilities, duties and security also. But sannyasi ki no security, no responsibility. Grihasthani ki security is there and responsibilities are also there. Okay. There is a lot of security, Swami. Family, children and ama responsibilities also. Are you ready for that? Go, enter into Grihasthashrama, Pravritti Marga. But don't postpone this goal. That is what everywhere Upanishad reminds us. You take choice, is there any option, Grihasthashrama, fine. But do Karma Yoga and Upasana Yoga. Karma Yoga, Nishkama Karma. Convert your Sakama Karma into Nishkama. Sakama Karma again keeps you in samsara. Always doing something for selfish ends. Either name or fame or recognition, appreciation or some love, something or other. Eppame Tambura Shruti Madri. I want, I want, I want. We do. I want, we do. Always try to give love, give care, give wealth, give knowledge. Every time give. What do you want in return? I don't want anything. Then how can you do it? Bhagavan is there. Ananyas chintayanto mam. He will take care of it. I don't bother. That mindset. Karma yoga. Then karma yoga purifies your mind. Then take to upasana yoga, Hiranyagarbha upasana and prakriti upasana, shakti upasana, Ishvara shakti upasana. Together. Upasana together, samuchaya. Karma yoga upasana samuchaya. Or upasana upasana samuchaya. You can take long route, not bypass route. Long route, karma yoga, upasana yoga, so many long route, vendamena. You require support. Long route is required for people, many people. That's why when young age itself they come to this karma yoga, upasana yoga, very easily they can come to jivan mukti, jnana yoga they can come. But they spend maximum time without religion, without God, without worshipping, without karma yoga, upasana yoga, up to 50-60 they spend. How they can get jnana in this janma? They cannot get. So, karma yoga, upasana yoga. Upasana yoga, samuchaya. Both you can. In entering in Grihasthashrama, purify yourself. Now, 9th to 14th, this is the topic. Then 15, 16, 17, 18, the Upanishad says, now after coming to Grihasthashrama, doing Karma Yoga, Upasana Yoga, whether you decide to attend the class or not to attend the class, again. Jnana Yoga, Sannyasa Ashrama topic is over. About Grihastashrama, who has taken Karma Yoga, Upasana Yoga, they spend their life fully in Karma Yoga, Upasana Yoga, not coming to the class, they will get Krama Mukti. If they come to the class, study Shastra, doing Panchamaha Yajna and doing Upasana, Dhyanam and meditation, exact Sandhyavandanam, all Upasana, Gayatri, Japa, Tapa, all they are doing, and studying Shastra, definitely they will get Jivan Mukti. But all people won't come like that. You see that people, how people are coming. People are interested only in Arthakama, or they are interested in Upasana only, that Upasaka will die and his pranas will go through Sushumna, Nadi and Brahmarandra, Shuklagati he attains. He attains Kramamukti. Some students vote for Kramamukti. I said, I don't know this Janma. Next Janma, I don't know. My students should not say like that. Okay? I don't want to hear that words. So Kramamukti is only for those people who never attend the class. Upasakas, they are all. And that the prayer verses are there. Last 16, 17, 18 verses are prayer verses. This Upasaka is seeking Hiranmayena Patrena Tasya Syapi Hitam Mukham Tattvam Pushan Apavrinu Satya Dharmaya Drishtaye. So Upasaka can choose that way. That is also an intelligent way, we say, Shastra says. If you come to this class straight away, after Karma Yoga Upasana, continue Panyanta class in Varlam. Even class itself helps like a Karma Yoga and Upasana Yoga. And sitting 1 hour in the class, listening 1 hour completely with attention is not a joke. So this class itself serves like a Karma Yoga and Upasana Yoga. And serving in the class, whatever required you have to do in the doing in the class is Karma Yoga. You can convert that karma into Karma Yoga. That is why some students come early and make that opportunity, make use of that. And they serve everything and they do. A lot of Karma Yoga they are doing. But I don't tell publicly because some students are unable to do. Really, they are making use of that. Coming early and putting chairs, carpets, lights and everything, arranging. This is Karma Yoga. What they will get? Chitta Shuddhi. Whatever way I can serve, anywhere, in the camps, in the class, or anywhere, whatever karma you do, convert it into Karma Yoga. That itself serves. Panchamaha Yajnas, Karma Yoga means understand Panchamaha Yajna. Do Daiva Puja every day. And do Pitra Karmas, Shraddha Karmas, Pritya Tarpanams. Many, many Pitrus, you know, they are all waiting for food. Amavasya Tarpanam, all those things, why we are doing? To seek their blessings. And Brahma Yajna, chanting every day. Few chapters, few mantras, Brahma Yajna, Manushya Yajna, serving to human beings. One way or other I have to serve whatever I can. Every day Panchamaha Yajnas and Bhuta Yajna, taking care of plants, taking care of other beings. Panchamaha Yajnas, they call it as Maha Yajnas. We consider them as a simple. Nowadays you cannot do Yajna Yaga and all. These Pancha Karmas called as Maha Yajnas. We are not showing much importance for them nowadays. Deeparadhana, lighting the lamp every day itself is Deva Yajna. Because in that Yajna, Agni Kundam is there, fire is there. Now, here also in Deepa, what is there? Fire principle is there. So therefore we have to understand first what we are doing exactly, what we are not doing, why we are doing. If we do this, what is the benefit? This benefit is going all the way ஃபார் வாட் பர்பஸ், இதெல்லாம் அறியாமலே வித்தவுட் நோயிங் இஃப் யூ டூ இட் மெக்கானிக்கல், ஒன் டே ஆர் அதர் யூ வில் கெட் டிஸ்இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இன் தட் வாட் ஃபார் ஐம் டூயிங். நோ எனப் டோன்ட் டூ தட் வே வித்தவுட் நோயிங் த பிரயோஜனம். அர்த்தம் இல்லாத வேலை வந்து வியர்த்தம் என்று சொல்லுவான். யூ ஹாவ் டு டூ வித் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங். சிமிலர்லி தியானம், உபாசனா யோகா, சிட் ஃபார் சம் டைம், மெடிடேட் அப்பான் யுவர் இஷ்ட தேவதா, மெடிடேட் அப்பான் தட் விஸ்வம், விஸ்வரூப ஈஸ்வர. 10 minutes கரண்ட் சிட், 24 hours பகவான் ஹாஸ் கிவன் டு மீ. 10 minutes மினிமம் தியானம் எவ்ரிடே. டூ ஜப்பா, நாம ஜப்பா, உபாசனா யோகா. பை ரெகுலர் ப்ராக்டிஸ் ஆஃப் மெனி இயர்ஸ் you see the change in your personality, in your thinking, everything. Bhagavan himself gives jnana yogyata and guru prapti, shastra prapti, jnana prapti. That is moksha prapti. What is that? Moha nivritti, shoka nivritti. Therefore this upasaka gets krama mukti if you make use of karma yoga, upasana yoga in this life. Come to Jnana Yoga, you get Satyo Mukti, Jeevan Mukti. So Upanishad concludes that for Upasaka, Krama Mukti, Sukshma, that Sushumna Nadi Dvara, he remembers Ishvara Dhyanam, he does at the end of his life, and Marga Dhyanam also he does, and go to Brahma Loka. You know what is Krama Mukti? Why Upanishad talks about Krama Mukti and Jeevan Mukti? As soon as possible decide you want Krama Mukti or Jeevan Mukti. Adhikada, Krama Mukti is not so easy. You have to leave the prana through Brahmarandra, through Sushumna Nadi. That you have to remember that God at the time of death. That is also not easy. Then you have to travel through Shukla Marga. Then you have to go to Brahma Loka. There Brahmaji with 4 heads he teaches. 1 head Mundakopanishad, another head Isavasyopanishad. Another head he teaches Kenopanishad. Like that he can teach and you sit and listen. Because you have avoided here, suppose. You have to listen there. There also you get Mukti. Shoka Nivritti, Moha Nivritti, Jugupsa Nivritti is possible only by attaining Jnana. No other way. Nanya Pantha Ayanaya Vidyate. There is no other way other than this Jnana. Either in this Janma or next going to Brahma Loka and getting Mukti. Either Sadhyo Mukti or Jeevan Mukti. Or Krama Mukti, you have choice. How much choice Shastra giving? You see, either Sannyasa Yoga or Jnana Yoga straight away, or Grihastha Ashrama, Karma Yoga, Upasana Dwara Jnana Yoga, you can choose, or Upasana Yoga and go to Brahma Loka, you can choose. How many options are there in front of you? You have to choose. You have chosen, I know that. You are all working for Sadhyo Mukti. Apadana na chollikano, illaya. I have to say that only. All students are working for Sadhyo Mukti or Jeevan Mukti. Attending classes, that is the only way. Study. So with this, brother, Isavasyopanishad is over. And summary is also over. Shanti Patha together.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. ஹரி ஓம் ஸ்ரீ குருப்யோ நமஹ ஹரி.